Hey, I'm Ryan Lopez, personal chef Kevin Durant.
First of all, he's my brother, but he's my chef, and he makes sure I get the right fluids and foods in my body for me to perform.
I was definitely a fan of Kevin and what he did and what he continues to do at a young age and just how he plays.
It's like I love to play basketball. He loves to cook meals for everyone, my whole family. He's always there when I need him.
I met Kevin out in Akron, Ohio. I was cooking for him, LeBron, and a couple other teammates. And I drove out there from Michigan to Akron. It's about a 3-hour drive. I got there that night at 10 o'clock, and I went to bed, woke up at 5, and none of the grocery stores were open. So I found a guy that was out at 6 o'clock. He was selling corn. So I bought a whole bunch of corn for him and started shucking it outside the grocery store. I mean, that's how much I wanted it.
Ryan came and kind of cooked for us. And as soon as I tasted the food, I was like, you got to come to OKC with me. And he packed everything up and moved out. And he's packing up and moving to the Bay with me as well. So I'm excited about that. He's been huge for me, man. He's gotten me better and stronger and bigger and, was able to last a long season. So he's very important.
I definitely feel like I'm part of Kevin's team here and what he does and his success. We've been together for 5 years now. I think we get along well because we kind of have the same mentality. With Kevin's job, I mean, he is always looking to be the best. He's always looking to strive forward and do more things. The same with me. I'm always looking to step the game up with my cooking. I think we kind of share that similarity there.
We're gonna head to a local farmer's market and a really cool specialty shop. Anytime I can get anything fresher from the farmer's market, I do it. It's just, it's better. It hasn't been sitting on the shelf as long. It hasn't been processed. If you're looking for a high quality product, you have to use high quality ingredients or fresh ingredients.
Bringing organic and fresh products is something that I've stood behind since I've been cooking. And really it's kind of taken off as local markets kind of start producing more and popping up more.
So we're gonna do a coconut corn curry sauce to go with our snapper. So really fresh corn, super sweet, has a great flavor to it. Some of these peppers we're gonna use in an escabeche sauce to go on top. We're gonna grab some whole wheat pasta today to go with our pasta dish. Grab some chicken breast we're gonna put on top of our pasta.
It's just high quality product and it's fresher, so in that aspect, it'll taste better. And that's what we're ultimately looking for, is the best product for it to taste the best.
Just gonna grab some tomatoes too to go on top of the dish. We're gonna roast these, blister them, and then put them right on top of the pasta course. We'll pick some really nice local fruit and kind of fruit that's in season as well. So kind of stay away from the apples and things like that.
Flavor and nutrition, it can be challenging, but being able to marry those two, I do a lot. So I definitely take the time out to be able to marry those. And it does take time, it does take time.
Got some great vegetables. We got some great local produce. We're gonna head to the kitchen and start cooking and get ready for the meal for Kevin.
I got started when I was about 16 years old. I started as a busser, went to culinary school, and really just fell in love with food. The creativity, the love, the craft, the work ethic that you have to be at a top level is something that I really fell in love with. You can never be at the top of this game. You can never be your best. You can always strive for more, and that's what I fell in love with. during game days. We try to keep things pretty healthy with pastas, sweet potatoes, whole grains. He's on a set schedule, so I need to make sure he gets fed on that set schedule and that he's fueled for the game. I'll try to make sure that he has a lean protein, a starch, and vegetables. He loves fruit. He's a big fruit guy. On cheat days, you know, maybe some chicken wings or some tacos or something like that. But definitely trying to take food and put a spin on it, put a little healthier spin on it if we can, is what my mission is with them. Over the 5 years, I've kind of understand his flavors and his profile and kind of developed a good relationship food-wise, you know, with his palate and what he likes.
He knows my palate more than my mom probably knows my palate.
Kevin loves tempura fried shrimp. Big rice guy, he loves rice. Sea bass, that's one of his go-tos.
I fell in love with sea bass when he started cooking for me. That's like the one thing I have to have all the time.
Kevin hates Brussels sprouts and raspberries. I rarely have them in the kitchen.
He just surprises me every day. I don't tell him what to cook. He just brings up whatever he wants, and you know, it's usually great.
So this is almost cooked, right? 5 minutes in the oven.
I definitely think about nutrition and how much fuel he needs for the game. That's something that goes into my menu.
In order for me to perform the way I want to perform, I need some good energy in my body, and he provides that for me. When you don't have that luxury, it's easy for you to eat out every night. I wanted to bring back that sitting at the table in front of with everybody and eating on top of having good, healthy meals. So he provided that for me, and it's been great. He's always looking to get better, too.
Each and every day you get up, you have to, you know, kind of think about your craft, and I think Kevin does that. I do that.
More than anything, he's my brother first, and he's very important.
I'm very thankful that I get to work with Kevin. He's a great guy to work for. I'm very intelligent guy. He's very much a foodie too, which I like about him. I wouldn't want to work for anybody else.